avoiding mistakes on Catholic's part. They played well. They were, for that most part of the game, it was tied. Maybe they were losing by one. But that game last night against Cootstown just proves to you that Catholic can compete with a tougher competition.
Yeah, Catholic. And overall, in terms of standings, overall not a big deal. Looking at each period individually, they generally control their own destiny. It's going to be unlikely that the winning team loses two periods
yes,
here.
Yes, absolutely. You know, and we're pulling out all the scenarios too. Like, what if St. John Fisher takes a point from Bloomsburg in the game prior to this one? You know, what if, who wins what period? Honestly, I'm not trying to think about that, because right now all I can think about is that Catholic need to be on the winning side today. If they get on the winning side, more than likely they're gonna be the overall points leader. But this Penn State Harrisburg team, they're looking really big, looking really a little quick, and obviously they're a little bit bigger in stature. Obviously that's not a hard thing to do against the Catholic team. Catholic team is really not big in size, but Catholic could kill you with their speed, and I think that's going to be another crucial factor here tonight. They're going to need to look to the wingers, specifically Duchesne and Jenneru, looking for that quick flank along the side there, and obviously Kevin Rigotti continuing to have a great tournament so far. Do we know who's in goal today?
It is Joe Aldretti all day long. Originally, the plan was for the two goaltenders to split time. It is the sophomore the whole way as the plan right now, unless a tragedy occurs here against Harrisburg. The Nittany Lions have had a good season so far. They're one or two standing points behind Cootstown in their conference, in Division II conference. They lost to Cootstown, who Catholic played yesterday, earlier in the season, 4-1. But overall, from some of the other opponents that they've played, a good, well-rounded Nittany Lions team should be here this morning. It's gonna be a tough game for both teams overall, because you can tell in warm-ups both teams are gonna have to dig deep after the two games that they played in the last couple of days. It's not gonna be an easy one, as both teams seem like they're hurting just a little bit before this game. Nobody's out on the Catholic side, but we know a couple players are struggling a little bit more than others this morning in terms of just bumps and bruises. So,
well, John, it's a quick turnaround. It's not easy to play three games in a row. All these teams have proved that they could be competing with the higher caliber programs, especially Catholic, who's made big statements. They didn't have any walks in the park. They tried to take down, cover the competition. But Penn State Harrisburg's been controlling this tournament so far, and this one's going to be a doozy.
I do have games getting started right now. Do have some news that it's the backup goaltender here in net, number 33, as a shot comes in from a low angle by Catholic. The starting goaltender is out today for personal reasons. So Harrisburg is going to have to dig deep for this game, as another shot comes in from Catholic and is covered by number 33 in net. So we will watch Osfkok, something like that. I'm not even going to try. 33 in net. Osifchuk? All right. That's the only time you're going to hear it, folks. as Catholic re-enters the zone here, it's Clohessy. There we go. We're getting it right. Entering the zone, sent around the boards. Behringer picks it up, now sends it down low to Kevin Rigotti. Rigotti up top to Clohessy. Sent in and went wide. Now stuff attempt on the goaltender through the paint, and we get a stoppage of play as the net is knocked off its moorings.
Bit of an early start here for Catholic, trying to use that speed along that right flank. It was Kevin Rigotti trying to do a little stuffing. Penn State trying to control the front of that crease, and they're doing a good job of it thus far.
It is Sorensen taking the faceoff. The Nittany Lions will win it back, but Harrisburg seals shot, scores! It's Devlin Powell, and Catholic is on the board first. 1-0 here with 18:56 in the first period. Sorensen picked it up, and it was a pass through the paint to Devlin Powell, waiting for it on the far side, and just an easy putback from the freshman.
Another backdoor goal, John. Catholics been doing that well thus far. Big goal for Devlin Powell, the freshman from Colorado.
Catholic wins the faceoff, shot in by Powell. Rebound off the glass. And Catholic will fight for it behind the net. It's Powell there, he'll lose it to PSU Harrisburg. And they'll send it all the way down for an icing. So Catholic getting an offensive zone faceoff.
John, bit of an opposite start here for today's game. Last night against Kutztown, Catholic looking very slow, very sluggish. It was a tough time. Probably the first 3 minutes of that game were spent all in Catholic zone.
We were getting nervous.
I was very nervous. I was very quiet. I was holding my breath for a long time.
It is Cassie sending a shot in. That one goes high. Stuff attempt in front. Rebound. Oh, somehow 33 was able to get over to make that save. Another shot from the point. Deflected wide. Puck gets sent through center. Does not find a Catholic stick. And now PSU Harrisburg trying to get it out. And the Nittany Lions do. To center. Now into the defensive zone for the Cardinals. But PJ Keegan there to collect. And now over to Duchesne. Duchesne hit hard, sent into the penalty box, and pops right back up as he almost went over the boards. Catholic in the offensive zone. It's Kevin Rigotti. Now 19 collects for Harrisburg. The Nittany Lions trying to get it out, pressured by Rigotti. Now Cassidy, but number 28 skates it. And into the offensive zone, he's stripped by Brendan Scott as he enters the zone. Catholic not able to get it out, though. Holding it here. And now we'll move it up with Duchesne and now Sorensen. Sorensen, under pressure, enters the zone, tries to drop it back. But the drop pass, not efficient. And Brendan Scott has to keep it in. He'll send one in that goes wide. Possessed by Jenner. Jenner puts it to the top of the zone. Now Santos keeps it in and gets it in deep. His shot goes wide. Jenner from a low angle, shot out in front. Saved by the goaltender. Sorensen looked to find the back of the net there.
Catholic looking very urgent, John. Trying to stomp right in front of that crease there for the goalie. Travis Duchesne sent over the visiting team penalty box. Trying to say what's up to us over against the boards here.
It is 1-0 in favor of Cardinals after the Devlin Powell goal in the first minute and 4 seconds. Catholic will lose the faceoff, get sent back to center. Cardinals try to rally in the puck, but it is Harrisburg taking it to get their first solid offensive push of the day. Trying to find space. Not really successful. Now loose in front of the net. Had a little trouble there was the Catholic defense. Now able to push it to the corner. Catholic fighting for it along the boards. And it is Jenneru picking it up and skating it out. He's in 2-on-2 with Devlin Powell. Puts on the brakes here is Jenneru. Holds at the faceoff dot. Sends one high. Kept in by Behringer as it rings around the boards. Catholic out in front. It's Artel. Artel tries to backhand it, and that's saved by number 33 in net and sent out to center with 15:55 left in the first period. Catholic sends it back in, loose along the boards. The Nittany Lions able to clear it out of the zone, but Behringer will send it right back in as Tushuk takes the spill trying to fight for the puck. Him and Wallace working together, and the puck will leave the rink. We got low glass here in rink one of the Aston Iceworks facility.
John,
for all those tuning in on Live Barn.
I have to say, great shift there from Brendan Scott there, number 5 in red. It's a lot of key defensive stops on that shift.
Puck blocked down by the Nittany Lions. Now a cross-ice pass, touched ahead by number 36. And they will get it deep in the Catholic zone. It's Clohessy. And he will pick it up and skate it out. Now dials it back into his own zone, tries to flick it forward, and it will leave the rink once again here.
Nice little souvenir there. Can't keep the pucks here in college hockey. You can't.
Yeah, we lost about 8 pucks in our first period of our first game.
Susquehanna, yeah, the pucks get flying.
It's PSU Harrisburg. In the neutral zone, we'll send it in off the faceoff. Number 9 has it in the corner, given a little bit of trouble by P.J. Keegan. Tries to put it in front of the net. It's shoveled down, now loose in front. Shot, goal, it's 36. On the putback. A sprawling attempt by Algretti. But it's the Nittany Lions tying it up here.
Another rebound given up by Allegretti. Tough play for the defense to clear on that one. Penn State doing a great job of swarming on that rebound. We got a tie game, 1-1.
14:46 to go. First chance for Penn State Harrisburg. 18, I believe, with the assist on that play. 19 with the assist on that play for the Nittany Lions as they start again here. It's 24 at the top of the zone. Sends one in. Loose out in front, and that's a goal! Two back-to-back quick ones from Penn State Harrisburg.
Tough play there. Another same similar goal as the first one. Joel Allegretti having a tough time controlling those rebounds.
Save the initial. Puck was not cleared out, picked up by Harrisburg. The official call on that is 81 with the goal, and then 20 and 24 with the assists. Harrisburg, once again, we get a delayed penalty.
It's going to be a slashing call, John. Penn State's going to go on the man advantage here.
So a rough couple of minutes at the 14:08 mark for the Cardinals.
Sorensen's going to go off for slashing here. It'll be a crucial power play here for Penn State, looking to capitalize on these back-to-back goals here.
It was all Catholic for those first 4 minutes. Last two have belonged to Harrisburg. Harrisburg possesses. Puck goes down low, below the net. Now flicked on to the other side, put in front, and Catholic able to put it to the boards as PSU Harrisburg maintains possession in the offensive zone. 1:40 left on the power play. Sends it to the near corner. Now around the boards to the far corner. And it's 58, holding now below the net. Back to 58, now up to the point from 72. He'll take a blast. That one gets deflected wide. 58 now, 72 again. Now down low to the faceoff dot where 58 waits. Shot right out in front. Rebound covered by Algaretti with a great glove save on the initial shot. And he will cover. 1:13 left on the power play to the Nittany Lions. 13:21 left in the first. It's a 2-1 lead for Harrisburg. No love wasted here so far.
Denny Jenner was pumped on that Catholic bench here, John.
23, holds it. Now sends it down low to the near side, and bad pass. And Catholic will try to clear it out. Hits the rafters on the clear attempt, and we get an in-zone faceoff, unfortunately, for the Cardinals with 58 seconds left on the power play. Two the Nittany Lions. Nittany Lions win it back. It's number 28 now to the point to 6. Now back to 28. Now down low. Go to the Lions. In front. Shot. Saved by Algaretti. Great shot there. Great chance as they had a man screening in front of the net and passed it to him. Now 20 down low. Rebound. Loose. Catholic gets lucky there. Out to the top of the zone. Set one through the center. A little bit forced. Catholic not able to gain possession of it. A shot in. Blocked down. And Cassie trying to clear it out. Unable to do so. Up as far as the blue line and kept in. 17 seconds left on the man advantage to the Nittany Lions. 23 holds on the blue line. Takes a slapper glove by Algaretti. That shot looked to be going high, but a good save there anyways by the Cardinals goaltender. 8 seconds left on the power play to Harrisburg.
Harrisburg taking full control, John. They're doing a great job of possessing the puck, working their point men. Matt Klohesy playing that penalty kill most of it with one glove on.
Harrisburg wins it again. Powell gets down for a block. Loose in front. Cassidy picks it up and it's 5-on-5 even strength. Catholic still not able to clear it out. Now they do to the streaking Sorensen. Sorensen under pressure though takes a high shot that hits off the glass and Sorensen is hit hard in the corner. Looks to be slow getting up. He will though as he'll poke check it away from number 36. Puck loose. Tries to get it backhanded to Jenneru. That pass was tipped. Harrisburg trying to get it out, and they will, to neutral. It's 58. 58 is hit by Wallace. Wallace will take it and get it to Duchesne. Duchesne dumps it in on net and covered with 11:28 left in the first. 2-1 in favor of Penn State Harrisburg.
Christian Sorensen shaking up on that play, going to keep a close eye on him on that bench. Looks to be hunched over.
It's Rigotti taking the faceoff. He will lose it back. Harrisburg has the majority of the faceoff win so far, halfway through this first. Santos controls in neutral, now set forward. Catholic unable to get it into the offensive zone though, and Harrisburg will try the other way. It's 17. 17 gets it in successfully. He'll take a slapper. That's saved by Algaretti. And we'll get a stoppage at 11:02. 8-5 are the shots in favor of the Nittany Lions so far in this game. Rigotti again for a defensive zone faceoff. Lose it back to Harrisburg. Harrisburg along the blue line. Bad pass. Catholic had a chance. And we'll get an icing. That was a close call as Cassidy was close on that one.
Bit of a foot race there, John. Honestly, we couldn't tell from here. Obviously, Coach Will Johnson says the complete opposite of the ref's call.
If the pass was a little bit better, could have reached Cassidy, could have been a breakaway there, or at least an odd man rush.
Catholic had to look for go for tape-to-tape passes. It's going to be crucial against a good team like this.
All the breaks that Catholic got against Kutztown, not getting here so far early in this one. Kutztown wins it, but unable to keep it in the offensive zone for them. And Catholic now get it the other way. Bad pass by Rigotti as Rigotti makes a nice hit as it's carried out by PSU Harrisburg. And Catholic will send it back in. Sent along the boards. Defense pinches in. But Harrisburg, number 6, will pick it up, takes a shot, that one goes wide, ringed around the boards. The Cardinals pick it up, it's Rigotti. Rigotti makes one man miss, it's a 2-on-1. Rigotti takes the shot, rebound, not there was Cassidy, he was looking for it, and it goes back out to neutral. Behringer up to Cassidy, Cassidy enters, looking for the backhand shot, that hit the outside of the net, and went wide. Now up top to Behringer. Behringer takes a shot from the point. That one changed directions, but hits the chest protector of number 33 in net. Big important push here from the Cardinals. 50 now controls for Harrisburg as Catholic will go on the change. So their boys are gassed here. Sorensen back on the ice, good to see him. As the Nittany Lions take it to neutral. It's 81 entering the zone along the near corner. battles for it is Catholic and Genru, and Sorensen come away with it. It's Genru. Tried to make a man miss, unable to do so, and Harrisburg carrying it the other way with 9-12 left in this first period. Not a clean entrance from Harrisburg as Clohesi getting it to center. Now Sorensen pushing it forward, pass a little bit too far ahead for Genru. And number 7 controls behind his own net. Get it out of the zone. Do the Nittany Lions. Catholic will send it right back in. Controlled by the Nittany Lions. They'll get it back out to center. Hit by Wallace. As Harrisburg was trying to leave their own zone. Catholic able to put it back in, but don't hold possession. Another failed entrance or exit by Harrisburg. Clohesi was tripped up there a little bit, and the puck will go into the Harrisburg bench for a stoppage of play with 8:20 left in the first period.
Back and forth action, John. It's going evenly so far here. Obviously, the scoreline's not even, but great action from both teams here in this first period.
It is Artel taking the faceoff. He'll lose it back to Harrisburg. Harrisburg moving it forward. Keegan battling for it in his own zone. It's Harrisburg, though, that possesses. 36 now up top. Sends in a shot that goes well wide. And Wallace is there first. Tries to clear it out. Doesn't get cleared out. Sent into the goal crease. And Algaretti with an easy glove save there with 7:54 in the first. 2-1, still the score here in favor of Penn State Harrisburg.
Joe Algaretti having some great vision there, being able to track the puck. You can tell from those first two Penn State goals that Catholic need to avoid traffic in that crease, because that's where Penn State Harrisburg have been swarming against the Catholic defense.
One thing we didn't get against Kutztown yesterday was people in front of the net. Harrisburg, it's a big part of their play.
Yeah.
Out in point, it's number 24, looking for a deflection, almost had it. But Algaretti was there just in time. Another shot. That one goes wide from the point. Catholic gains possession. It's Santos. Santos to center. Now brings it in. He'll send it in. And that one is deflected high and out of play. Offensive zone faceoff coming here. Catholic really needs to start winning some of these face-offs, because I think they've won maybe 2 or 3 all game so far.
Looking like the Rangers with a lack of face-off wins there, eh, John?
It's Rigotti taking this one. And Harrisburg again will win it. Unable to get it out. Sent it on net. Cassidy in all alone. Sends one to the center. It's Duchesne. Duchesne with the goal. 33 had to slide one way. Duchesne put it the other way. On a great pass from Boomer Cassidy with the assist. And it's tied 2-2 as the captain Cassidy tries to rally his troops here. 7:05 left in this first period. Big goal from Catholic.
Big goal from Travis Duchesne. You can always rely on him to get one of those big moments. With great leadership there on that pass from Boomer Cassidy.
Powell collects off the faceoff. Sends it in, goes wide. Genru is there as the freshman is pressured by the Harrisburg defense. Big hit in the corner from number 6, the captain for the Nittany Lions. They're able to clear it out to center, but Behringer collects. And now we'll rifle it back in. Almost went for an icing, but it looks like a Cardinals player touched it on the way through. Now Harrisburg looks to go the other way. It's 71. Working against Behringer. Shot in, glove save from Algaretti. 6:29 left in the first. 2-2 after that goal from Duchesne.
Nolan Behringer on that play, making sure that Joe Allegretti had some vision on the puck. Great job of Nolan Behringer, number 22 in red, to push the Penn State forward to the side there.
Harrisburg winning another faceoff. Can't keep it in the zone, though. And it's Jenneru stealing it in the neutral zone. Sorensen pushes it ahead into the offensive zone. And Sorensen carries it to the corner. Sends it out front. That one goes all the way through and will leave, go into neutral. Powell now sends it in. He'll go off for a change as Catholic looks to get fresh bodies. It is Jenneru out in front. He makes a great steal, tries to stuff it past number 33 in net, and it is covered for a stoppage with 5:52 in the first. Great individual effort. He was all alone in there trying to get his boys a clean change and was able to make some offense happen for him.
Absolutely, John.
Catholic can tie a period with Harrisburg in terms of standing points as it's sent all the way down towards the Catholic side. Low angle shot covered by Algaretti. Sent around the boards. It is 28 trying to keep it in, and he does. Now sends it down low to 20. 20 battling against the Catholic defense. Sent up, kept in by number 24, and sent right back down below the net. Where 20 battles for it some more. Duchesne will pick it up as it's loose out in front. And he sends it all the way down to Cassidy. Cassidy has a chance here on an open goal. Shot saved by 33 right to the gut. Cassidy was just a little bit behind the PSU defense for a moment there. Couldn't collect it in time to get a breakaway chance.
Could have looked for a pass there. He had Rigotti back door, but elected to take the shot right into the bread basket of the PSU goaltender.
It's Sorensen. Sorensen loses it. Another win for Harrisburg. Send it around the boards, but Sorensen will pinch in here and keep the Nittany Lions defense on their toes. 20 now, able to get it out. Brendan Scott holding and will send it right back in to the offensive zone. Harrisburg's there first. Jenneru, and now Powell possesses a shot out in front off of the pass from Powell by Sorensen. That gets sent high and out of play.
Sorensen with a clear chance in that slot there. Great offensive awareness from him. Just able to get that pass.
Couldn't keep it down there for the senior. Catholic wins a faceoff here. Sent one along the boards. Sorensen below the net. Tries to get it to Jenneru. Jenneru just pushed it wide. Now loose out in front once again. But Powell was just a little bit ahead of that play. Pushed out to center. Now pushed back into the offensive zone for Catholic. Jenneru chasing as Catholic goes for another change. Sent in on Algaretti from neutral zone. Ends up going wide. And now it's to Shook the other way. Tushuk sends in a shot, gets deflected high, not out. And Harrisburg picks it up. It's 58. 58 with speed, sends in a shot. That one also goes wide. Another shot off the bounce, off the boards. Doesn't make it through. And now Catholic gets it to center. Had a chance for an offensive break. Ends up turning it over in the neutral zone. And Artel tries to work it forwards. Turnover in the offensive zone for Catholic. It's Tushuk now. Tushuk battling. Can't get to the puck as he's pushed off. And it's cleared to center. Santos will collect in neutral. Santos now has a little bit of room. Gets it to the boards. Gets his own rebound. Pushes it on net. And we get a stoppage of play. Looks like the ref lost sight of it.
Exactly what happened.
Puck went to the corner.
Yep.
But
Soon as the ref can't see the puck, he's got to blow the whistle dead. You know, it's unfortunate because sometimes the puck just happens to bounce out as soon as that whistle's made. You see it in the pros all the time there, John.
Harrisburg changing on the stoppage. It's Rigotti taking the faceoff. He'll lose it. Duchesne keeps it in momentarily. And now Harrisburg able to get it passed into the offensive zone for them. It is fought for by the Catholic defense along the near side. Puck battle here at the boards. And it is now along the other side. Harrisburg able to keep it in the top of the zone. It's 28-28. Hit by Santos and knocked off his feet. But Harrisburg maintains possession. It's 28 again. He's being hit again by Santos. Now at the top of the zone. Down low, all alone was number 20. As he got underneath the Catholic defense but couldn't handle the pass. And we get a stoppage of play here as the puck looks to leave the rink. 2:18 left in this first period. A goal here by either team would be huge. But it is 2-2 as we stand. Catholic can survive in the standings if we lose a period or tie a period.
But only one.
But only one. It is Catholic trying to get it out of their own zone. Wallace gives it some effort. Now Sorensen trying, and the Cardinals will. Sent back in for delayed offsides against Harrisburg. Clohesi will possess, sends it into the neutral zone. Harrisburg sends it right back in for another delayed offsides. As Clohesi now works it forward, it's Powell. Powell taking a shot, deflected, wide, picked up by Sorensen. Sorensen in front of the net. It's Genereau. He'll drop it back, and a slap shot from Wallace, then to Genereau on a wide open net as Genereau gives Catholic a chance at a full point in this first period. It is 3-2 in favor of the Cardinals.
Big goal here from the Minnesota lad, Dennis Genereau. Could be a very clutch goal in this first period, John. Still got a minute 26 left to play.
Rigotti will take the face-off at center, loses it back. It's 28 and now 50. The defenseman kept in a chance right out in front, but the pass was too far ahead from Cassidy. Now it's Duchesne. Cassidy behind below the net and will transition to the other side below the net to Rigotti. Now up top to Rosner. Rosner takes a blast. It hit a PSU player hard, and he is down in a heap taking that puck off. No stoppage of play, and now we will. That was a long wait before the whistle, as 20 is in pain as he looks like he took that puck off the ankle.
We saw that happen on Friday when for Susquehanna.
Yeah, Susquehanna probably has a broken...
Probably a broken leg there.
Probably a
Friday.
Broken leg.
Yeah,
no,
it was tough.
You know, no call.
As soon as you see someone down, you gotta blow. But
EMT is probably waiting in the center of the ice, or in the restaurant. So we'll get him over. As number 20 looks in pain, favoring that right leg. Catholic lucky to not have any serious injuries so far. Great initial keep in by Duchesne. Off the opening faceoff, was able to make a steal, send it right in front to Connor Cassidy, who had a clear chance on net. As we get restarted here, Catholic wins the faceoff, puts it in the corner with 50 seconds left in the period. It is Cassidy. Now up top to Santos. Santos trying to keep it in. Fought for by Catholic. PSU Harrisburg willing to just play it behind the net. Now tries to get it out, and it's Rigotti who will take it away. Sent back down below the net here. Possessed by Catholic. It's Rigotti. Rigotti under pressure from 24. He tries to pass it up to the point. And Rosner unable to collect. 20 seconds, now 17, as Catholic pushes it to center, now pushes it into the offensive zone. 12 seconds on the clock as Rigotti into chase, and it will leave the rink with 7.6 seconds left on the clock. So one last offensive push. Looks like Catholic will get the point for the period as they lead 3-2 after the goal from Genereau. Catholic wins the face-off. Powell holding. Chance out in front, and Harrisburg able to cover just as the horn sounds. So Catholic with 11 points now in the standings. 13.5 is the number to beat.
For Bloomsburg, yeah.
For to pass up Bloomsburg. So 2.5 points away as we will get a partial intermission here, but they will not cut the ice. What did you see from that first period?
I saw even hockey, John. You know how great both of these teams are playing. You know, I guess I got to give the edge to Catholic because of the scoreline, but Penn State Harrisburg, there was that point where they just kept scoring back-to-back goals where you looked as if they were the better team. But that goal by Duchesne ended up being a very crucial factor for that tie. Sorry, it's very cold. I'm trying to process my thoughts here. But then that goal by Dennis Genereux, you know, this has been an occurring trend for Catholic in this tournament, is that Catholic have been capitalizing on late goals. We saw it yesterday in Kutztown, a goal from Kevin Rigotti and a goal from Connor Cassie that came late in the period. So this goal is very big. It's going to determine the outcome of this game, but there's still 40 minutes left to play, John. And if we can quote Steve Wallace, who we were talking to before the game, he says there's three 20-minute games that we have to win. Right now they won one of them, so if they can win two, maybe even a third, things are going to be flying high for the Cardinals.
Catholic is 4 points behind Bloomsburg in goal differential. It is Harrisburg who's tied with, well, was tied at the beginning of this game with 10 standing points as the boys get set up. So we don't have to worry about Harrisburg in terms of points and point differential. But if we get to that 13.5 mark, it is Bloomsburg with that goal differential advantage on the tiebreak. So we really need 14 points or a 5-goal lead at the end of the game to win this tournament. It is Clohessy. He will lose it. Almost a big chance for the Nittany Lions. But Behringer able to keep that puck from getting too far out of the zone at a 2-on-1 opportunity as one is sent into the offensive zone for the Lions, sent right in front of Algaretti. Now a shot as he easily grabs onto that. Shot coming from the top of the zone, no screen, like we saw in the first period on that play.
Urgency from PSU Harrisburg early, trying to look for that backdoor shot. Just a little too far ahead there. Could have
shot right off the faceoff. Loose out in front. Algaretti looked like he lost a sight on it after it hit his pad. Catholic able to recover and push it to center. PSU Harrisburg entering again. Keegs lays a big hit, but Harrisburg able to maintain possession. It's 19 on the top of the zone. Now along the near side, number 28, and now down low to 23. Right out in front, a shot from 81 as he was fed from 28, but couldn't get enough of a stick on that one. Rosner under pressure, looks for Genereux. Genereux will tip it into the neutral zone where it's possessed by number 19. And 23 will get it wound up here once again. Poke checked away by Keegan. And momentarily looked like it was going to be sent out to center. But it's the Nittany Lions with a shot here in the offensive zone. Blocked down by Catholic. And now Powell on a 3-on-3 brings it into the offensive zone for Catholic. Harrisburg a little bit confused there as two players collided, one with the puck. But they will hold on to possession as they steal it away from Powell. Tries to send it to neutral where it's possessed by the freshman Santos. And Santos makes a man miss, sends one in, takes a shot. That saved low on number 33 in net. 17:50-48 left in this second period. 3-2 in favor of the Cardinals as 81 carries it for the Nittany Lions. Makes Scott miss. Now is hit big time by Connor Santos. That is sent to the corner. He had a real good chance, and Santos came out of nowhere to lay the body. Catholic gets it to center, can't possess. Now Santos again in his own zone. We'll send it forward for Enzo. Enzo touches it into the offensive zone, now fights for it in the corner. Nittany Lions successful in the battle along the boards, and it's number six bringing it loose out in front for 17. Now Garetti had a great poke check away to spoil that scoring chance. Catholic battling for it along the top of the zone. 17 tries to send it towards the net, but it's collected by Santos. Santos will play it off the boards forward, and Catholic will go for a change. Harrisburg sends it the other way. Santos collects. He's got Duchesne. Now Rigotti. Rigotti plays it to himself with help from Duchesne. Now Rigotti trying to push it forward, and number 72 with a great individual effort keeping it out. 20 the other way. Gets pushed off the puck by Clohacy. An unsuccessful entrance to the zone. Now it's Cassidy with a 3-on-1. He's all alone. Shot. Rebound. Still loose. Rigotti picks it up. Shoot. Gone wide. Rigotti picks it up again. Sends it to the... No. Holds it along the near side. Puck hits the back of the net in behind the goalie, and he will cover after a great push there. Great chances by the Cardinals.
Great offensive chances for both teams, too. But that last chance from the Rigotti, Duchesne, and Cassidy line, just trying to find that rebound. Great rebound control from Penn State Harrisburg.
Cassidy cherry-picking big time on that play. Allowed Catholic to get the offensive opportunity. A shot set in from the blue line by Clohacy. That one saved and sent all the way down the other way. It had a chance for a breakaway, but Algaretti comes out of his crease to paddle that towards the boards as the Cardinals try to get it out, and now they do. It's a 2-on-1 developing with Duchesne and Rigotti. Duchesne sends in a shot. Bar down! It's 4-2! With a great shot. Beats the goaltender high. And Duchesne, with his second of the game, gives Catholic a 2-goal advantage and one step closer to this tourney title.
What a shot there from number 24 in red, Travis Duchesne. Just putting one right where the goalie can't get it. Barred down, top corner. Great goal for number 24 in red.
Catholic wins the faceoff, sent in by Powell with 15:30 left in the second period. Harrisburg able to clear it out. It's Rosner collecting in his own zone, trying to get it out of the defensive zone, and kept in by Harrisburg. Harrisburg sends one in, goes behind the net, now loose out in front to 28, but it's poke checked away, and Catholic with a 2-on-2 with Powell and Genereau. Devlin, Powell, just a little bit ahead of the play, and they are called for offsides.
Tough play there. Devlin Powell doing the best that he can, trying to extend that skate of his on the blue line, just got a little too far ahead there.
15 even. They're showing up on the clock as we got full stands here on both sides of us at Aston Iceworks. Won by the Cardinals. Duchesne takes a shot. Glove save and then covered by number 33. We said this at the beginning of the broadcast. 33, the backup goaltender for PSU Harrisburg. The starting goaltender out due to personal reasons today. Started the tournament and... sadly could not be here for this game today. 4-2 is the lead. Cardinals in the offensive zone. Now cleared out. Duchesne tracks it. Gets it to Rosner. Rosner hit in the back, and he will draw a penalty there. And that will be the first power play to Catholic. 14:28 left in the second. 2 minutes I believe, for a hit in the back.
Yeah, just me checking from behind, penalty there. First power play of the day for Catholic. Looks like it's going to be Sorey taking the faceoff here.
Sorensen gets it back to Duchesne. Duchesne takes a shot that just went wide. Rebound collected by Genereux. Genereux behind the net. Now sends it towards the front of the net to Duchesne. Duchesne had a good amount of pressure, though, and it's sent to the corner. Now Genereux below the net. Genereux looking for Duchesne again up top in front. That one doesn't get through. Sent all the way down towards the Catholic side. It is Cassidy after Genereux took a spill in neutral. Cassidy will take it in. Puts on the brakes. Now Sorensen. Sorensen battles for it in the corner. Harrisburg tries to clear it out, but unable to do so as Santos keeps it in with 1:11 on the penalty. Santos bluffs the shot. Now back to him. Santos delivers to Genereux. Genereux sends it through. Duchesne, Rigotti, he hit the post. Rebound, still loose. Rigotti backhand does not go there. 19 tries to clear, and he will, as Rigotti had an A-plus chance as a beautiful, received a beautiful cross-zone pass from Genereux as the puck leaves the rink here with 41 seconds left on the penalty to Harrisburg.
Probably the first missed opportunity of the game, John, for Catholic is that Rigotti opportunity on that power play there. Could have made a big, big lead in this period. Would have been a two-goal lead in the period, three-goal lead in the game itself.
Catholic wins it. It is Steve Wallace. Wallace and Cassidy get into the offensive zone, and it's sent right back out with 30 seconds left. Delayed offsides, and now Catholic brings it in. Once again, it's Powell. Powell brings it to the corner. Under pressure by number 72. Now Catholic will get it back up top. It's Clohessy. He'll send in a shot. That one was saved. And rebound collected by Steve Wallace. Now it's Powell. Powell whiffs on a pass to Clohessy. And down low from Nolan Behringer gets saved by the goaltender as the defenseman somehow was found underneath the net or below the net and sent one in for a low angle shot. And we are even strength here now. 4-2 is the lead in favor of the Cardinals with 12:27 left in this second period. Harrisburg winning the faceoff will get it as far as Keegan, and Keegan will send it back into the offensive zone. Second exit attempt by Harrisburg, successful, and they'll enter in. Sends in a shot, and they beat Algaretti. Down low, and it is 4-3 in this game. And just as importantly, it is 1-1 in this period.
Tough goal to give up there for Catholic. Big goal for Penn State Harrisburg, you know, to tie this period.
It's Sorensen taking the faceoff. He'll send it towards right in front of our scorekeeper's box here. And Catholic possesses. It's Sorensen. Send it forward. Skies it. Touched with a high stick. We'll get a stoppage of play as it was played with a high stick by Harrisburg. And then they touched up. So Catholic will get an offensive zone faceoff because of it. With 11:49 left in the second. Faceoff occurring on the glove side, kept in by Keegan. Keegan hit in the corner, popped right back up. And the puck is sent around the boards and picked up by Harrisburg. Harrisburg to center, poke check by Keegan doesn't go. And now Harrisburg trying to drive to the net and it's shut down by Rosner. It is loose in front of the net, sent in by number 81, and 81 will score. And it is 4-4, all tied up with 11:22 as it seems like the Penn State Harrisburg goals come in twos.
Another misery compiler there for Penn State Harrisburg, able to tie this game. Now they lead the period 2-1.
We knew this was going to be a tight one, and it is not disappointing. Catholic moving it forward. Rigotti is there along the near side boards, now driving towards the front of the net. Loose. Cassidy had a chance. Now Cassidy collects. Santos sends in a shot. Rebound. Just went wide. Duchesne had a chance. Harrisburg possesses, clears it out. Santos collects and sends it right back in. Hits it off the glass high. And Cassidy into chase. Now Rigotti below the net, under pressure by 17. Rigotti back up top. It's Scott. Scott sends one in. That almost was deflected on net, but ends up going wide. Now Rigotti back below the net again. He'll hold. Looking for open space, finds Duchesne, and it just got through past Duchesne as he'll ring it around the boards. Takes an odd bounce, and they're able to clear it towards center. Nittany Lions are. And Catholic will go for a change as they send it back in. Now 24 for Harrisburg. Now 8 will send it forward. And Clahasey plays it along the boards. It's Genereau. Genereau and Wallace sends it forward to Wallace. Wallace touches it forward. Onsides is the Cardinals. And the puck sits now behind the net. Wallace and Harrisburg battling for it. Clohesi now sends in a shot. That goes high. And Powell and Sorensen try to keep it in the offensive zone. Unsuccessful there effort as Clohesi working to play a good bit of defense. And great play there by Clohesi. As Catholic goes on the advance the other way, it's Genereau. Genereau just couldn't drive to the net like he wanted to. Very close. Now he's held up. No call. Catholic with the chance. Puck in front of the net. Somehow did not go in. Catholic keeps it in. It's Powell. And now over to Clohesi. Sent into the corner. Clohesi keeps the puck in once again and sent along the boards. Wallace. Now back low. Down low to Genereau. Genereau finds Clohesi. And PSU Harrisburg had a chance the other way as they stole it off of Clohesi's stick. But it's Genereau here. Genereau, he's in. Oh, just had it poke checked away. Another shot here from Catholic. That one ricochets and it goes in. Looked like it hit the glove of 33. And just got deflected enough where it was lofted into the air and dropped in. And Catholic has tied up this period and got the lead in the game, 5-4 after that goal.
Big goal there from the captain, Connor Cassidy. Crucial goal in this period.
Genereau with the only assist on that play. That is a big goal, coming with 8:38 left in the second.
Coach Will Johnson looking for an explanation on some plays there on that last shift.
Yeah, it was Genereau was kind of tangled up, and I think Coach might want an explanation on a no call and a holding. But it seems like a reasonable explanation from the referee. Catholic wins the faceoff, and it's Rosner and Behringer in their own zone, have a little bit of pressure, but now able to send it up to Cassidy. Cassidy touches it forward, touch to Rigotti. Rigotti will dump it in. Backhand, trying to get it back to Rigotti was Cassidy's effort. But PSU Harrisburg, they're on the defense. Catholic sending it back in. 50 for Harrisburg is there first. The captain delivers a hit, but Harrisburg pushes it to neutral. It's 87 and now 23. 23 looking to try to take a shot. That's poke checked away by Rosner. Great stick check there by number 20 in red. Affleck sends it in again. 50's there first. Cassidy will strip momentarily. Now battling against two Nittany Lions. And they will send it all the way down. Icing washed out as Behringer collects and Harrisburg goes for the change. Behringer sends it to neutral. It's turned over. Number 20 possesses for the Nittany Lions. Now he's got a chance in. Number 20 driving to the net, shot, and that one just went wide. Chance here, low angle. That one hits the side of the net and stays out. Now 20 again from a low angle. Tried to backhand it. Catholic's defense was there, and now they will push it towards center and get it out. Good to see 20 back out there from the Nittany Lions. Had a lower body injury in the first period. Nittany Lions bring it back. It's 20 again, working against Connor Santos. Great defensive play by Santos, and he'll flip it to center once again with 6:42 left in the second period. Jenner driving to the front of the net. Santos with a slap shot. That is a save off the stick of number 33 in net, and it's loose behind the net as Catholic fights for it. Now on the near side, Enzo sends one towards the front of the net. Kept in by Scott off the clear attempt by the Nittany Lions and sent along the boards.
Denny Jenner a bit shaken up on that last play.
They'll need him to finish out this game as Harrisburg goes the other way with speed. It's 81. He's got a chance. Great save, Algaretti. And that deflects up and out of play with 6:03 left in the second.
Big save there from the Chicago native, Joe Allegretti. Able to steer that puck away and out of danger.
Great A-plus chance there from 81. C came in. Santos took a dive trying to get in front of that puck. Catholic tries to gain possession off the faceoff, unable to do so. 50 keeps it in and sends it down below. It's Clohacy now, battling for it along the boards. Wit to Shook. Harrisburg looks like they will gain possession off of it. Sends one to the front. Chance here, shot. That's a great save, Algaretti, as he loses his mask. Gets a blocker on it. Possibly hit the post off the blocker, and he will dive backwards on top of that puck as he got just enough of it and will readjust his mask with 5:36 left in the second. Fantastic from Algaretti.
Losing his mask there, John. I got a little scared, but Joe Algaretti able to sprawl on the ice in his crease, making a big save, able to freeze the puck there.
Algaretti sometimes has trouble with that blocker, but no trouble there as Catholic, possessing off the faceoff, tried to get it to Cassidy, who was streaking towards the opposing net, but it was tipped away. Now they got Cassidy. Cassidy with Clohacy on a 2-on-1, and he will ring it off the crossbar. The captain with a chance. Cassidy once again tries to get it to Rigotti, but lost the handle. And now it's pressured the other way. Algaretti comes way out of his net to clear that out of the zone. As PSU Harrisburg was coming in hot. Catholic the other way. It's Rigotti behind defense's net. Rigotti holding. Tries to flick it up top to Wallace. Wallace puts it on net, but low and covered by 33. Thank you all for listening to this early morning, Sunday morning game, 10:40 and Eastern Standard.
It's a nice little treat before Sunday football, John, wouldn't you say?
Oh, for sure. We know some of the other games were at bad times and weren't sure what the turnout would be on a Sunday morning, but thank you all for being here. As we hit the 4:33 mark, it is PSU Harrisburg 1-on-1. Behringer with a great defensive play, and then the centering pass shut down by Behringer once again. 28 holds for Harrisburg. Cycles below the net. And we get a stoppage for an unknown reason. 4:13 left in this period. The period is tied 2-2. And it is the Nittany Lions going on the power play. Rosner coming off. That is for a hook. 81 takes the faceoff for Harrisburg and wins it. 72 bluffs a shot, now passes it to 28. 28 with a low corner shot that almost beat Algaretti, but he was there in time. Now back up top to 72. 72 skates it, sends in a shot, rebound cleared out by Catholic with 140 on the penalty kill. If the score holds right down, Catholic will get a much needed half a point, which they can't afford in the standings. It is 72 bringing it in. Now 20, skates right to the front. He had a chance there, but it was saved there by Algaretti. Now 72. 72 down low to 28. 28 on the near corner, sends it in for 81. A slap shot on a one-timer that's saved by Algaretti. Now up top to 72. 72 over to 28. 28 back up top to 72, and that pass was a little bit too far, and it'll go into neutral zone with 55 seconds left on the penalty kill for the Cardinals.
Joel Algaretti making key saves here, John.
It's Santos sending it around the boards, kept in by six. Six once again at the top of the zone, over to nine. Nine in front to 81. 81 couldn't handle the pass. And 24 holds now. Set in front. Rebound loose. Algaretti not there yet. Still loose. And 81 comes away with it. No whistle called as that was under Algaretti for a while. Shot, great save. Looked like it hit Brendan Scott. Another shot. That hit Algaretti up high as he lost his stick. Catholic with a big clear on the penalty kill with 5 seconds left. And now even strength goes the clock with 2:10 left in the period. It's Rigotti in the offensive zone. He has it hit away from him, and Sorensen will try to re-enter the zone, but he is offsides.
John, what a penalty kill there for the Cardinals. I was just pumped looking at the bench, seeing the emotion. Joe Algaretti, man, the kid is standing on his head. You know, the four goals, don't give him any credit. But the kid is just playing a great game, and we know he can play dependable games for the Cardinals here.
Unsure how he didn't get a whistle on that last play as Sorensen puts it lightly into the offensive zone, but picked up by Harrisburg and dumped in with 1:53 into the Catholic side of the ice. It's Clohesi. He's under pressure from 36. Sends it over to Wallace. Wallace fighting for it along the boards, and he'll lose it to the Nittany Lions. Up top to seven. Seven with the shot. Redirected. Still loose. Somehow that stayed out. Algaretti lost his stick once again. But a delayed offsides will help out Catholic immensely. Powell holds with 1:20 left in the period. Sent to the center. Pass does not work out for Powell. And he poke checks it back into the neutral zone as the Nittany Lions try to enter. Now they'll try to dump it in here. And Clohesi and Powell work to get this out. They have Jenneru. Jenneru working one-on-one, puts it behind him and lost his edge. Picks it up again. Holds and now gets it to Duchesne. Duchesne rips a shot but did not get the full puck. Catholic still possessing. It's Jenneru below the net, now skates to the near side, tries to drive to the center, gets a little bit stopped up there, and it is taken away by Harrisburg. Santos will keep it at center with 20 seconds left in the period, and now Jenneru sends it in, but possessed by Harrisburg there. And Harrisburg looks to work the other way. It's a 2-on-2, 20. Back check by Duchesne, and we get another penalty call in here for an elbow. And it's number 20 coming off for the Nittany Lions with 5.5 seconds left in this second period. Got a lot of stuff coming through over the broadcast. real life here, kind of like reality TV sometimes. Dude, it's good stuff.
College hockey's the best hockey kind, John.
He'll have a, after this 5.5 seconds, have a full intermission. Cool down as Catholic takes a shot. Rebound in front, right as the buzzer sounds. And number 33 covers. So, a half a point received in that period for Catholic. That's a big half a point for them. I believe PSU Harrisburg, with that half a point though, can also still win this tournament.
Oh, absolutely. This third period is going to be the most intense period of hockey that we're going to see, John. It all comes down to this. You know, it's going to be a heavy-fought period. It's going to be very physical. It's going to be very entertaining, you know, from the fans' perspective. So we're going to see how these teams can execute their game plans in this next period. I don't know about you, but I think I'm ready to get a little warmed up for a couple minutes and make a little restroom break, if you know what I mean.
I am ready for that as well, as it's cold here in Rink 1 of Aston Iceworks. Do want to say just how incredibly even this game is at 5-4. Catholic will go on the man advantage to start the third period, which is a huge help, but the only thing that we can't have happen here, neither team can have this happen here, is a tie at the end of the third.
Yeah.
Because that means that no team wins. There is no overtime. It will be counted as a tie. And therefore, neither team would be able to win the tournament. So it has to be a regulation win for Catholic or PSU Harrisburg in order to pass Bloomsburg in the points for the tournament. So we're going to take a quick break. It's going to be dead air for a little while here, unless you want us to listen to the Zamboni sounds in the background, but I think we'll shut it off as we got nobody back at home base to play music. But stick with us, we're still here, and we'll be back with the third period. 5-4 is the score. Catholic on the man advantage as the leading Cardinals go into their intermission. All right, hello everyone. We are back here with this third period. Catholic leading 5-4 after getting a half a point in the last period. Need to at least get a half a point in this next period and get the win. Obviously, it has to at least be a half a point for Catholic in order to get the win here. As they lead it now and can't give up or just holding on to a slim one-goal lead. If they are able to win, they'll get the 2 points additional that will push them over Bloomsburg. For a tie, I believe they get 1 point, and that will not be enough, depending. We'll have to run through that scenario exactly if that has a chance of occurring, what that would mean for the Cardinals. But as of right now, we're just going to say that Catholic needs to win this period or at least tie this period. Get the win, and they will have clinched the tournament victory here at the East Coast Showdown as we get ready here for the third period. Catholic on the man advantage as puck drops at center ice. Catholic wins it. It's Santos, and now Rigotti. Rigotti back there at that point position for the power play unit. Catholic having trouble getting it out of their own defensive zone. Santos and Rigotti, wind up again. Now get it to Duchesne. Duchesne skating in, sends one high, deflects off the goaltender and goes back behind the net. Now Jenneru. Jenneru drops it to Sorensen. Sorensen with a shot straight to the gut of 33, who has done a good job in filling in for their normal number one, who is out today due to personal reasons.
Great dish there from Jenneru on that pass there to Sorensen.
1:20 left on the power play. Catholic possesses off the faceoff. It's Rigotti. Rigotti takes a shot. That's saved by the goaltender. Still loose out in front. Still loose. And now goes to the corner to Duchesne. He'll send one through through center. And that one gets deflected. Now Rigotti takes a shot. That one's saved by the pad of the goaltender. And the Nittany Lions will clear with 48 seconds left on the power play for the Cardinals. It is Rigotti. Rigotti in his own zone, working still with Santos. Back and forth, that puck goes between him. Rigotti tries to send it up, now he does. But Wallace has trouble getting to it. It's cleared out again with 27 seconds. Santos now to neutral. Carries it, and onsides is Catholic just barely as Cassidy got back just in time with 13 seconds left on the power play. It's Wallace. Wallace sends it deep to Cassidy. Cassidy below the net puts it forward through the paint as even strength is finally reached, and Harrisburg tries to get a break with number 20 coming out of the box. 20 working against Clohesi. And great play by the sophomore lacrosse player there on defense. Catholic gets it to center. It's number 9. Trying to possess for the Nittany Lions, but Cassidy will gain overall possession and skate it in. Now it's Harrisburg back the other way. It's 19, trying to get around Behringer. Low angle shot. Loose, another shot, and that is a goal! Bad rebound off the low angle shot given up by Algaretti. And it is tied 5-5 with 17:22 left in the game.
Tough goal there for, given up there by the Cardinals. It's the same scheme there, John. It's those rebound goals that Catholic just can't seem to clear.
It was 28 on the goal for the Nittany Lions. Been calling his name a lot so far today. As Catholic has it in their own zone and now try to spring it with Powell and now Jenneru. A little bit too far ahead for Jenneru and now a little bit too far for Powell. And Harrisburg will gain possession of the puck, and it's 28, the goal scorer, taking it the other way. Once again, no overtime in this game. Whoever wins it in regulation wins the tournament. If it's a tie, neither team wins the tournament, as Powell and Jenneru move into the offensive zone. Shot! Dyvall scores! A routine shot from Devlin Powell, and Catholic retakes the lead in a big way. As the freshman sends it to 6-5.
Devlin Powell using that left flank, using some speed there, put one 5-hole against that Harrisburg goalie. Now Catholic take a lead, and clearly it's all tied up again, John.
Bad goal given up by number 33 in net. His first truly bad goal here so far today. Been pretty solid overall. Catholic in their own zone, tries to get it up to Cassidy. Cassidy in a foot race now as he flicked it ahead, and he will get there in time to wash out the icing. Clohesi at the top of the zone. Around one defender. Now gets it into the corner to Rigotti. Rigotti up front to Behringer. Behringer from the point, and that is saved by the goaltender, number 33. Now loose, it's Rigotti. Rigotti poke checked away by the goaltender. Another shot, rebound. Cassidy couldn't get a solid handle on that. Behringer keeps it in. Now Rigotti blows the net. Back up to Behringer along the blue line. Now over near side to Rigotti. Behringer rips one. That one goes wide, hits off the boards, and ends up on the stick of Duchesne. Duchesne back down low to Rigotti. Rigotti backhand, rebound, cleared out by PSU Harrisburg. Penn State going the other way. It is a shot high from number 58. That one will ring around the boards. We get a delayed offsides here as Harrisburg puts it into the defensive zone for the Cards, and Cards will slingshot the other way with Sorensen. Scott now. Jenneru on the near side. Jenneru over opposite side to Rosner. Rosner rips the shot. That one was saved by the goaltender. Great movement there from side to side by Catholic. Harrisburg leaving their own zone. Unsuccessful the first time. Now here's 72, who will just hold on to it, working with his defensive pair number 7 to get it out of their zone. They will. Rosner will collect the pass, though. Bad pass by Rosner through center, and Harrisburg will send it in. Now go for a change. Scott's there. Over to Wallace, up to Sorensen. Sorensen makes a man miss in neutral zone, enters offensive zone, sends in a shot. That's blocked, but rebound collected by Jenneru. Shot now high from Rosner. Loose in front momentarily, and then hit to the side by Harrisburg, and now out where Duchesne will collect. Catholic battling for it right at the red line. Duchesne strips it from number 7 and enters the offensive zone. Now number 7 able to get Duchesne to just push it to the corner. Steal again here from Duchesne. Duchesne working against 7 and 74. Along the board, still loose. Duchesne gets it to Rigotti. Rigotti drives to the net. He was tripped. No call there. Atrocious no call in my mind. And a goal there. And it's Powell again from the point position. Devlin Powell retrieved the puck off a nice pass as Catholic tried to recover off of the spill from Rigotti. Sends in a shot, and it is Rigotti getting the tip-in goal, and it is 7-5. 13:21 left in the game, and Powell has a great third period here with a goal and an assist.
Another swift reply from the Cardinals, John. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Still a lot of hockey to play here. And it is Harrisburg who will need those 2 points and able to have a chance. Harrisburg enters the zone, low angle shot. That one goes behind the net. Puck still in low. It's 81 possessing along the boards. Now Santos is in, giving pressure. And 21 will come out of it, puts it in front of the net. And no one was there. 24 will keep it in and continue the pressure on the Cardinals defense. Catholic now able to clear it out. Goes all the way down. No icing. Yes, there's the icing call with 12:28. So it's a defensive zone faceoff for the Cardinals.
Great effort there from Dennis Jenneru trying to outskate the Penn State defenseman. Just was a little short on that play, but great effort all around.
They've been giving the benefit to the defensive team on those. Cassidy was close, Jenneru was close, but both were called for icing. They're trying to remove any potential injuries. 81 taking the faceoff against Sorensen in the defensive zone for Catholic. Now up to 72. 72 sends one in. That changed directions drastically and gets sent wide. Now 20. That one also hit somebody up high and went wide. 20 again below the net. And now battling for it. It is Catholic not able to clear it out. And now Powell will get it to Jenneru in center. Jenner working one-on-one with number seven. Now 72 comes in and will help his teammate out as Harrisburg possesses while Catholic goes on the change. It's Behringer now. Behringer sends it to Rigotti. Rigotti on sides and in. Has a little bit of trouble with his entrance. And Harrisburg able to clear it out. The other way, it's collected by Behringer. Behringer gets it to center. And Duchesne enters with Cassidy. Boomer Cassidy tries to lay down a hit on number nine, but not able to get it to center. And now 36 in pursuit of it into the Catholic zone, but it's Rigotti there first. Now Rigotti into the offensive zone, under pressure, loses his edge as he tries to spin around. Catholic able to maintain possession in the offensive zone, sends one in from Clohasey, and that one goes wide. Catholic here on another offensive push, sends one in, goes wide, right out in front of the net. Clohasey has a chance, and that one hits the outside of the net. So Rosner now, he'll take a shot. That one gets deflected high and out of play.
Catholic show its emergency, John. It's been back and forth, back and forth. Catholic seem to have the edge, or edging now in the shot department, 33-26 in favor of the Cardinals.
It is 7-5. Both goals created by Devlin Powell in this game. One gets credited to, or in this period, one gets credited to Rigotti. Has a chance right out in front, and it's a goal off the faceoff. It was pushed from the faceoff towards the front of the net by Sorensen. And it looks like maybe Steve Wallace and Sorensen worked together to get that passed the Harrisburg goaltender, and it is 8-5 here with 10:20 left. And the dream of winning the East Coast Showdown is alive here for the Cardinals, up by three.
Big goal there from Steve Wallace. Excellent feed there on the faceoff play from Sorensen. Catholic looked at pressure again.
It's Wallace trying to get a centering pass to Jenneru, but that is spoiled by PSU Harrisburg. 28 tries to bring it in, cannot establish possession though. And it's Wallace the other way. Wallace sends it to the corner. Now up top to Scott. Scott couldn't handle it, so he tried to play it with the skate and missed. PSU Harrisburg able to clear it out. Bad pass to Scott in the defensive zone. He has to chase. And it's Harrisburg gaining possession, loose out in front. And now it's Cassidy the other way. Cassidy all alone. Looks to beat the goalie 5-1, and he does. 9-5 as the floodgates open here in the third. And the captain gets his first goal of the game. And his third point of the game. It is Nolan Behringer getting the assist, as it looked like it was possibly a pass to the point position from PSU Harrisburg. Got past both defensemen. And Cassidy was all alone. Shot in here and now covered by PSU Harrisburg.
John, I feel a little better now. I've been very quiet, I'll admit. Rooting for the boys here, trying to stay impartial, but, you know, I'm wearing the colors, we're repping our colors, and it's a bit of a comfortable lead, but they can't give it up now, because Penn State's a capable team that could just pull off a dramatic comeback if need be.
It is Santos getting a great play in neutral zone to maintain possession of the puck. Now Rigotti driving to the net. That one is taken away by Harrisburg. Shots 36-26 in favor of Catholic, as Harrisburg will dump it in on net from the neutral zone, and the puck will leave play here. So we get a stoppage. Catholic playing all Division II teams of the DVCHC League. This is the top division. Catholic has had the toughest schedule, I believe, of the tournament.
But one of the teams, yeah, they've had one of the toughest schedules. It's definitely not a walk in the park.
But have a chance to impress here, big time. Catholic in the offensive zone. And that will leave the rink once again. For a stoppage with 8:23 left in the game.
John, who's impressed you so far in this game? If you can pick one person, I know it's tough, but...
I really like how the captain, Connor Cassie, has stepped up here in this game. With the 3 points, I think Devlin Powell, too, has really jump-started this third period.
Can I give you another name?
Yeah, sure.
Steve Wallace. I think he's had a great game overall so far. He has a goal to his name. He's been playing on the top, on a more of a bigger line. I think he's had a great game overall. And I think I can tell that because his mentality going into that game, we were able to talk to him. He was the one that said, you know, it's 3 periods that we have to win, right? And they won the first one. They tied the second one. And it looked like Penn State, Harrisburg, had the advantage going into this third period. But all these swift replies from Catholic seemed to bend in their favor as we have 8 minutes left to play in this third period as Joe Allegretti possesses the puck.
Oh, bad pass. Yeah, bad pass there from Algaretti. It's a ricocheted off a skate. Almost was very dangerous. But we get a stoppage play the other way. Is Catholic able to clear? But cleared a little bit too well for an icing.
Yeah, Denny Jenner looking to deflect that puck there right in front of the scorekeeper's box. Just a little too far ahead.
Number 6, the captain for the Nittany Lions, taking the faceoff against Christian Sorensen. Sorensen gets it to Steve Wallace. And Wallace will clear it out. Now, like you were mentioning with Steve Wallace, you know, had kind of a tough season so far in his senior campaign, but has had a major presence and feels like a little bit more of a leadership role here at this tournament. PSU Harrisburg trying to get it into the zone. Algaretti comes way out of his crease, unnecessarily, in my opinion.
Yes.
To try to play that puck, as his defense was there. And now a bad turnover. Catholic able to push it to center. Almost had a break with Enzo, but couldn't get past or around the Penn State defender. And Penn State, content with just possessing, now they'll send it into the offensive zone. It's 81. He has a wraparound attempt. Another shot there. Rebound is cleared out momentarily, and now cleared out the rest of the way as Wilson Shook has a chance as he's racing down the puck to chase this puck. Misplays it a little bit. Gets it to the corner where he'll fight for it and lose out to number 72. 72 will carry. Avoids a hit upon entry into the Catholic zone. And now the puck is tipped up and out of play with 6:20 left on the board.
Great chance there from that third line there. Big of a defensive stop there from Will Tishuk, I would say. Almost had a bit of a breakaway. Saw the Penn State Harrisburg defenseman closing in on him.
It is 9-5 here in favor of the Cardinals. Just 6:10 away from a tournament victory. Rigotti will clear it out. And it is Cassidy behind the defense. He'll send one in from a low angle. This hits the pads of number 33 in net for Harrisburg. Now 20 the other way. 20 had 28 a little bit ahead of the play. And Harrisburg is called for offsides. Stoppage at 5:50. Shots are 37-28 in favor of the Cardinals. Big story though, 9-5 Cardinals.
Absolutely, John. We knew that the only stat that mattered was the scoreline of this game. There were situations where You win the period, lose the period, tie the period. In my opinion, I was only focused on one scoreline, and that's the scoreline that has the Cardinals ahead 9-5.
Number 20 driving to the net is able to be pushed off by the Catholic defense. But the Nittany Lions will draw a penalty in the offensive zone as Catholic touches up. And we'll see what the call is. But it looks like it's going to be Scott. Freshman defenseman Brendan Scott going off for a trip and a game misconduct. So Sorensen coming off as well. And it is going to be a big penalty kill here. It is going to be a 4-on-5, though, still for Catholic, as the game misconduct will not go up on the board.
No, yeah, Christian Sorkin's just going to be done for the night here.
It is PSU Harrisburg entering the zone, takes a shot. That is saved by the goaltender, Algaretti, and now it's Jenner who able to clear it out with 1:32 left on the power play to Penn State.
And if I can quote my favorite broadcaster, Sam Rosen, we're now listening to the Foxwoods Final Five.
5 minutes left in this period, in this game. Catholic sends it right back down as PSU tries to enter once again. And they're 4:40 away. If they can hold on to this four-goal lead, 9-5 the score as 58 sends one in. He gets a goal. Ricocheted oddly off of Algaretti. Little celebration there from PSU Harrisburg. They know that they have a long way to go, but they will get the lead a little bit shorter. It's 9-6 here with 4:28. Left in this game.
Coach Will Johnson's going to look for a timeout. Need to regroup the boys after that penalty and that misconduct there to Sorensen.
Sorensen might be able to come back for the last 30 seconds. Is that correct? Is it a 5?
No.
Or is it a 10?
It's going to be a 10 misconduct.
Okay.
Yeah, so his night's done, unfortunately, but Catholic just need to regroup. They need to just play their game. They need to be poised and control and not be able to just make stupid mistakes in terms of giving up the puck, in terms of just clearing the zone on rebounds. If they do that, this result will hold.
Sorensen definitely looks like he needs a break as there is some good amount of steam coming off his head as he sits in the in the box for the rest of this run. He's been fighting hard all game and has been a big part of this Catholic effort all weekend long, but especially in this game, as the timeout ends for the Cardinals. Catholic looks to get set up at center. Puck drop taken by Rigotti and sent into the offensive zone for the Cardinals. It's 19. 19 will hold below his own net. Now flicked on forward to 17. 17 will dump it in past Behringer, who goes on and retreats. He's pushed in the back. No call there. But Duchesne will pick up the puck and tries to send one off the boards.
Did that go in the crowd there, John?
And that did go in the crowd and is sent back on the ice. There is no delay of game calls here, even though that didn't touch the glass, because the boards are, or the glass is just so low.
Very low, yes.
I mean, I am taller than it. It's about,
yeah,
it's about 6'2". I'm 6'2". It's about 6 foot high.
I'm in clear danger.
Harrisburg wins the faceoff, sends in a shot with 5-on-5 hockey playing here. And that puck is deflected out of play once again. With 3:53 left, Catholic leading 9-6. If the score holds, Catholic will have 14.5 points in the tournament, which is good enough for the tournament title, as we get a penalty coming here once again to Catholic. Looks like a slashing. No, it is coming to Harrisburg. Sorry, I got confused on that. It looked like...
I got scared for a second too, John.
They called it when Catholic touched up.
Yeah, there was a play. It was a 50-50 puck, so they were both going for it, but it's going to be a slashing call.
So, it is Catholic on the power play. PSU able to clear it out. And Santos retreats to collect. To Duchesne in the neutral zone. 3:27 left on the clock as Duchesne will skate around back behind. And now deliver it to the near side boards. To Genereau. Genereau back to Duchesne in a low angle shot. From the Colorado native, Travis Duchesne. That is covered by number 33. 1:34 left in the penalty to PSU Harrisburg. And 3:14 left in the game. It's we got 28 here in the box with us for the slashing. God bless Catholic from 28. You heard it here, direct quote.
Cheers, bud.
Catholic possessing below the net. It is Cassidy. Cassidy now skates it out and sends it right back down below to Duchesne. Catholic seems content with just possessing here so far in on this penalty. Now straight, nice pass from Genereau looking for Duchesne. Duchesne couldn't deliver on that back post. Catholic still possessing. It's Genereau again along the near boards. Now sets it up in the center for Cassidy. Cassidy sends one that hits the stick of the goaltender and sent all the way down. Almost had a breakaway chance for PSU. As Duchesne enters with Catholic once again, PSU will try to get it out, and Rigotti will send it into the stands once again, trying to get it in deep with 2:03. 2:03 is the distance away from the East Coast Showdown title with 22 seconds left on the penalty to number 28. Catholic wins the faceoff. Behringer rips a shot. That was blocked. Sent around the PSU boards by PSU, kept in by Devlin Powell. And Powell gained possession, flicks it on, back for Behringer, and then back to Powell on the far boards. Sent across from Powell, but no one was there to put it on net. The penalty expires to number 28. Even 5-on-5 hockey now for the last 1:35 of this game. It is held in the corner by Catholic in the offensive zone. And now taken away by number 6 for PSU Harrisburg. Harrisburg not able to clear it out. It's Powell again. He'll put one on net. And that is saved by 33. 40 shots now is the total for Catholic against Harrisburg's 30. Been a great game so far with this last 1:18 coming up. 9-6 is the lead for the Cardinals.
John, they played a great game. They had a great third period so far. Still time left on this clock for, you know, hockey is such a scary sport where anything can happen in such a little amount of time as Penn State looked to break out.
Harrisburg with a 3-on-2. They're content with dumping it in with 1:08. It's Harrisburg possessing, sends one in front, has a chance here, and that looks like it may have hit the crossbar. Another shot sent in by Harrisburg. That one saved by Algaretti. Now from the point, sent in, went wide, rebound, number 17, tried to get a low angle chance. And Catholic now able to clear it out with 42 seconds left. Possessed by Harrisburg, trying to get back even, down by 3 this last 30. Catholic, game possession, it's Rigotti, he has a poke checked away. And dumped into The offense is owned by PSU Harrisburg. It is 22 seconds left on the clock. Duchesne now through center. Duchesne enters the offensive zone, has it pickpocketed by number 24 from the Nittany Lions. And a backhanded shot as 58 entered the zone. With 2 seconds, now three. And that is it. Catholic soars over PSU Harrisburg for an East Coast Showdown title. Great game here from the Cardinals, showing their dominance over the highest division or conference in the DVCHC League. As they two teams go out to shake hands now, great stuff from Catholic all weekend long, and a great win here today against PSU Harrisburg.
John, it was a very impressive performance here from Catholic. It was just like an even game overall. You know, both teams played a great game, but in the end, at the end of the day, Catholic are on top. Now, do we know if it's official? Is the title secured? I mean, we have to see the standings again, but
the only way that it is possibly unsecured lies in the hands of Columbia. Mm-hmm. Columbia has 8 points currently, so they will need to score all six as Travis Duchesne shows his excitement over by the radio broadcast crew.
We want to say hi to Devlin's mom. Devlin's saying hi to his mom there in Colorado. Hey, Dev, great game today, bud.
Dev had a great third period getting the scoring started. But, it basically came down today. Oh, sorry, I was explaining how Columbia could possibly win.
Yeah, we were interrupted there by Travis screaming his head off.
So, Columbia has 8 points. We entered the day with 10. We now have 14 and a half. So, if Columbia can steal... No, my math is wrong. Catholic has it.
Catholic does have it.
Catholic has it. Because Columbia would need
the shutout, right?
The max points they could get is 6. And because CUA tied that second period, that was the clincher. That was the nail in the coffin. That half a point is just enough to put it out of reach for Columbia. So it is Catholic who will take the trophy home here from the tournament in Aston, Pennsylvania. The East Coast Showdown title is held by the Cardinals.
John, this is a great weekend. You know, I had a lot of fun, not only just calling it, but getting to know some of the guys off the ice and spending time with them in the hotel. And you could tell that this team wanted it, you know. And Catholics come a long way. We look at it from 2 years ago when they only had 6 skaters against the Richmond Spiders, and last year winning the Patriot Division. And now they're in the American, and they just took down three high-caliber opponents there in this tournament. So overall, a great performance from them. And I know Coaches Will and CJ have done a great job coaching the boys there, and it's going to be a fun trek home back to Brookland and back to the campus of the Catholic University of America.
For sure. We want to thank you all for spending your Sunday morning with us. We know it was an early one, especially for some of you out on the West Coast. But we want to thank you for being here and taking your mass plans around around our game here today.
Hey, God loves hockey too, John.
God loves hockey too. We got the hockey gods on our side today for a Catholic win and a Catholic win of the tournament. So we want to thank you all for being here all weekend long. We hope that you have a wonderful Thanksgiving. We'll see you on the other side of Thanksgiving for the game against UMBC, I believe is our first game back So we're going to be at UMBC, and me and Jeremy plan to be at that game to bring you the radio broadcast once again for that. So stay tuned on what we're doing for that. But a great Thanksgiving gift, as I saw in the chat, from our boys from CUA brought to us. So hope you all have a wonderful holiday, and go and praise the Lord for a good victory here today.
Roll Cardinals.
That's all, folks.